Welcome to Beer Review Number 3, Special Halloween Edition. I hope you survive.
Welcome to Beer Review Bench Number 1, and it's time for our special Halloween beer review. This will be beer review number 3. And today for Halloween, we're going to be reviewing the Shipyard Brewing Company Pumpkinhead Ale. Now, the Shipyard Brewing Company is out of Portland, Maine. And they're a relatively young brewing company. They started brewing in, I think they started out as a pub, and then in 1994, they started brewing craft beers. And this is one of them. This is one of their seasonal craft beers. And it's a wheat beer with subtle spices. At least that's what it says on the website. We're going to find out. So, first we take the official beer review bottle opener. Stubborn bottle cap. And we have new official beer review glasses. And we're going to pour. Okay, now the color is not as orange as I would have expected. It's more of a golden color with a slight orange tinge. Not a lot of head. Head's dissipating rather quickly. And the head is pretty much white. The carbonation seems fairly light, and let's take a sniff and see what it smells like. Yeah, it smells a little wheat and some kind of spice that I can't quite identify. I'm kind of surprised being called Pumpkinhead. I thought that it was going to be more a darker orange and it was going to smell more like a pumpkin pie, but it doesn't. So we'll come and we'll do the taste test now. John, come on around so we can get your opinion. There you go. Take a sniff and tell me what you smell.
I smell the wheat like you did.
Mm-hmm. What about the spice?
Like an orangish orange.
Orange?
Mm-hmm. Hmm.
I'm not really smelling orange, but I am starting to smell something a little like clove, maybe.
Hmm.
Well, let's give it a taste and see what we can find out.
Definitely a wheat taste.
Smooth. Yes, definitely a wheat beer.
It's got a smooth taste to it too. No bitterness, no funny aftertaste or anything.
No, it's very light, very lightly carbonated. It has that slight indefinable spiciness to it, more than just clove, but I'm not exactly sure what. It really doesn't taste to me like pumpkin or pumpkin pie.
Can't can't put my.
It's slightly sweet, not overly sweet, not as sweet as the last beer that we reviewed, the Lagunitas, but it does have a sweetness to it, but the spiciness sort of offsets and balances the sweetness. It's refreshing. It's a very unusual flavor. I really can't quite identify the spices in it, other than, as I said, I think there's a hint of clove, but other than that, I can't identify it. If you're looking for a beer that tastes like pumpkin pie, well, this ain't it. It's not bad. I don't think I'd want to drink a lot of it, but one or two on a Halloween or during the fall would be just fine. Somebody handed one to me, I wouldn't turn it down. What do you think, John?
I agree. It's flavorful for sure, smooth.
Can you quite make out what some of the spices and flavorings are in it?
The only thing I thought was a little bit of orange, but there's some others I can't discern.
I guess my taste buds just aren't quite sensitive enough to pick out the orange, but I think I would give this a conditional thumbs up.
I agree.
Conditional in that, as I say, it's not something I'd want to drink on a regular basis, but occasionally, not bad at all. Well, that's the special Halloween edition of my beer reviews. I hope that you found it useful and interesting and maybe just a little
frightening.
Well, this is Spec Ops 56, aka Pumpkinhead, saying so long until the next beer review.
You may be leaving for now, but the nightmares will return.